expectations.
So when you're building a pipeline, there are a number of components. Of course, land is the largest component. Security is the second one. And with the, that's from the person building the pipeline. From the host communities, of course, jobs, livelihood in this kind of, in these communities that we're going to pass through, they are pastoralists, so they have animals to graze. And you can imagine if you're going to build a fence, that's 891 kilometers. And seeing as they've never ever seen another pipeline anywhere else, one would think that you would build a pipeline and have a fence around it, which is not the case. In this particular case, the pipeline is buried. And once it's buried, the grass grows on top of it, and basically animals can graze on top of it. So the issue is not there. But how do we engage and let the communities know about this? Today, unlike in the former times, where only you had an environmental impact assessment, where you dealt with animals and plants and how the environment was impacted. Today, we have the environmental social impact assessment, where we try and have as little impact on the communities as possible. So that means, of course, education. What can they expect in terms of how their day-to-day lives will be affected? And of course, one of the things that we obviously looking at is jobs. Now, most of the people have already said they don't want the jobs of cutting grass, digging ditches, and that sort of thing. And I think one of the things that has to be done is technical jobs. So we're not going to obviously be hiring petroleum engineers and civil engineers and people like that in large quantities. The people we'll be hiring are plant operators, welders, electricians, people who can lay fiber optic cables. And those are the jobs that are available. And I feel it's up to the leadership of these communities to convince young people that these are meaningful jobs. They're well-paying jobs, and they give dignity to people. And I think this is part of the problem. So it's a two-prong approach: the person building, the government and the oil companies, and the local communities who can then educate people on what is required, what education they will require, what courses they will need. I think it's important.